The outbreak of COVID-19 has impacted how we seek information through media. A very good evening to you all. I'm Sahwa Junaid from Management and Science Institute, Colombo. First of all, I would like to thank the SLMA for giving me this opportunity to present my research on information-seeking behaviors on COVID-19 through social and mass media in Sri Lanka. A deadliest virus has been originated in the city of Wuhan in China, which has been spreading throughout many countries in the world, infecting and killing millions of individuals globally. On 30th of January this year, it was declared as a global pandemic by the WHO. With the rise of social distancing and people seeking for updates of the virus, the use of social and mass media has increased. At the time when reliable information is more important to the general public on COVID-19, misinformations on COVID-19 are disseminating at much higher speed than the virus itself. My research is to focus to assess the use of social media and mass media in obtaining information on COVID-19 among the adults from 18 to 65 years in Sri Lanka. I have done a descriptive cross-sectional online survey where a pre-tested self-administered questionnaire was used to assess the usage, preferences, and trustworthiness of various social and mass media platforms. A sample size of 304 was achieved. The associations were determined by using the chi-square test, where a p-value of less than 0.05 was considered to be statistically significant. The mean age of the study population was calculated to be 30.6 years, with the majority of them being females. Out of some of the most popular social media platforms, WhatsApp, Facebook, and YouTube has been most frequently used to obtain information related to COVID-19, whereas WhatsApp is at the top of the most frequently used social media platform. At the same time, the trustworthiness placed on them was comparatively very low. A relatively higher percentage of trustworthiness was seen in Google+ and Twitter. Television was one of the most frequently used mass media in obtaining information related to COVID-19, followed by radio and newspaper. A higher percentage of trustworthiness was placed on television. Only about 52% of the population had always checked for the accuracy of the information which they had received related to COVID-19, whereas nearly half of the population had only sometimes checked for the accuracy, which shows that there is a higher possibility of dissemination of misinformation. Being educated only up to advanced level was highly associated with the frequent use of WhatsApp. Similarly, males were more frequent users of Facebook. Therefore, there is a high use of social media to seek information on COVID-19, which can be used by the health organization to disseminate timely and accurate information to a large population. However, the trustworthiness on the information received from social media is low. Therefore, mechanisms should be developed to monitor the information circulated on social media. Thank you.